Good morning, class. My name is Mr. Fen, and today we're going to learn how to repent for our mistakes. Okay, so last video, I did a few things, one of which was going up here and grabbing this little greeny bluish thing. Now, apparently, I ran into a bug when I tried to drop it in the old cauldron, which I will explain on the way. Actually, you know what? Yeah, hard save. I'll explain on the way as I grab this thing. Already bumped it though. Okay, so what's the deal with this thing and why didn't it work when I put it into the cauldron pot? Well, as I have it from Goldwell, apparently the way it works is this thingy has an invisible entity attached to it, which moves around with it. And that invisible entity is what triggers the pot to do the thing. I guess for some reason, you can't just have this do it. I don't know, it's pretty strange. But if you bump this around enough and get it caught or, like, you know, whatever, apparently the entity can sometimes become separated from the physical, visual thing. And maybe that's not gently enough. I don't know, we'll see. And, therefore it won't be around when you stick it in the pot. It's pretty weird. I don't know why you can't just have a normal object. But hopefully, bug can be, fixed. Because, yeah, what you gotta do is just gently put it down. Gently as you can. That might not be enough. I don't know how. Like, holy crap. This thing bumps no matter what you do. So that's it. Can't turn on my lantern. I can't imagine why. I mean, I'm teleporting this thing in front of my face, telekinesing it. So, obviously my hands are free. Oh no, not gently enough. Gotta remember, I can't mantle while I'm holding. Although I can open a door while I'm holding a body, so things are obviously a little weird, but apparently none of the testers had problems, so I probably don't have to be this careful, but God, I don't know, it's weird. It's probably because I banged it around a lot trying to put it on that sill. I don't know. Anyways, gently place it in the pot. There we go. Whoa. Can't hear you, buddy.
How did you get in here? You bastard thief will pay for this.
Huh? Okay. So this is the same, but something slightly more deathly looking. But I couldn't do anything there. I couldn't move or nothing. So I completed the ritual. Did that do anything? Was I supposed to pay attention to something in there? That was weird. That was weird. You bastard thief, you'll pay for this. Well, how? How will I pay for this? Well, at least it worked, I guess. That's a pretty strange thing to do, though. Seriously, that's it? And then there's a guy walking around who tells me I'll pay for it, and then that's the spirit realm, I guess? Doesn't look like a spirit realm to me. Okay, well, that's the ritual. Now, I still haven't got Lord Balkan's thing. Nor have I got the puzzle about the execution, which Westwood Sky's like, how cute? How is that cute? There's no clues. Why the hell do you think I have? Unless, of course, I have to go around here some more. Hey, stop flickering. What are you doing? You're flickering, obviously. Stop it! What? Wait. What? What? Oh, okay. So, the only I can think is to go back to the house and try to find some readables. I don't know, man. But Lord Balkan, let's keep his great value up there. Up sort of implies I'm going up, does it? Up, up. So this is the bathroom. I should probably just leave these open so as to notate my place in the world. Yeah, this is going to be the episode where I try in vain very hard to figure stuff out. Of course, the one time I said that I only might not figure something out, I did. So I should probably stop saying that I absolutely won't. Okay, this is the guy. The guy. Well, here's a note. Let me just read this. And there's that guy's room. Now, I did read this guy's journal. Now, if we're talking execution like in a metaphorical sense, well, here's a guy who died. After we finished dinner, he consumed a bottle of poison, after which he died. So there's Lord Balkan, there's this guy, there's one of his helpers. So there could be two of them. So there'd be like four people, but nobody really stopped the execution. I think that's a bit of a stretch, so that might not be what he's talking about. And this, okay, that's the couple. The happy couple who are in a really good movie that was super controversial because it was supposed to be about a kingdom and sunshine and oh, what is going on here? Okay, is this or is this not a brand new room? Probably not, although there doesn't seem to be anything here, so who knows? Wait a minute, I ain't been here before. Why haven't I been here before? That's funny. I wonder why I would want... It's not even anything special. It's suite 3. And there's nothing at all going on. Suspicious! Okay, so there's a zombie room, there's a couple room. There's the guy, and this is the nothing room. So, with that in mind... With that in mind then, if I go down the vents and I find... Okay, this is the kitchen. If I go down the vents and I find any room that is not those, I guess I'll... Oh, this is the office. Oh. It all makes sense now. Okay! See, I knew I wasn't completely sure if I'd done everything in this room. Awesome. So I guess this could just be an easy way up or something. I don't know. Poi hap. So if that's the case, I need to be going kind of this way. All the way over here and then possibly kind of over here. Dang it, I'm just looping now, aren't I? Yeah, see, that's the way to get down into the kitchen. So it should kind of be like maybe here? Maybe not. I don't know. Perhaps. No. That's the music room. Well, if this is the music room, then I should be pretty close. The office is just over there. Alright, also, this thing opened and closed the compartment. Just so everybody knows. So, okay, just make sure the office is over there, so if I could somehow find a vent. Unless, of course, I need to use some key or another. Oh, wow. Nice clip in there. So, maybe here? No? What's that? Here. Oh, is it here? Huh. You're kidding me. Even this is locked? That's ridiculous, man. That's gotta be it, too. What a joke. Why even bother to have a vent up here if... Why even bother to have a vent up here if... If you're just gonna have it locked same as the friggin' door is. What a cruelty. And what? Why is this guy... What's his story? Are you the executed? And none of my keys work on the office either. I don't remember. Honestly. I mean, the office, you'd think maybe Lord Balkan. And there's a letter that somebody needed to take to him too. Hey, go away. Does anyone have anything on their waist? Is kind of my question. I don't know why I'm looking in here. Okay, well, I'll go down to the first floor and start there and just kind of look around, I guess. So here's the management, I guess. It's the owner of the building. Let me take a quick look through here. Yeah, right, so that note didn't say anything, and neither did any of the others down there, as far as I can tell. A couple talked about John, and the fact that he's got weird meat. Oh, wait. This is Lord Balcon's place. Okay, right. See, another thing I forgot. Okay, it makes even more sense now. Here I come. Maybe I'll even learn about an execution here. Even though some freaking guy apparently said, "You don't need any more clues." Oh, come on, man. Don't be that way. I'm Finn. Revere me. Alright. What have we got? Nothing. It's Lord and Lady Balcon, and I'm leaning over them because sometimes people have purses on them when they sleep. Maybe rarely, but you never know. Okay. That makes sense. Well, I guess I can't... Oh, I can read? Okay. "Today I was feeling especially guilty of my addiction. You as well? So I decided to go to the church confession. After talking with the priest in great lengths, he forgave me for my sins. After this, he entered his personal chambers and returned with some of the drug itself. He told me it had been blessed by the builder and therefore was safe to use. It required a small donation, so it was pure, of course, and he said if I continue to make such donations, he will provide the holy drug." Wow, that's messed up. "This makes me feel a lot better. I even decided to forgive Dr. Marcus of his enormous debt in exchange for some voodoo potion of his. He put on some theatrics at dinner to try and impress me, but it completely failed. However, due to my good mood of my builder-approved Mandrasola, I decided to give him some leniency and forgive him. 400 freaking thousand go." So, it's him and that priest on the balcony as well? Wow. Yeah, you know, Mandrasola is pretty dark. I mean, it's kind of neat. It's neat that there's a hard drug around, but it's pretty dark. Probably darker than that spice from Thiefity Thief. Because, I mean, the mission, Mandrasola, you know, the nobles are like, "Oh, we're killing ourselves in a nasty fashion." Yep, well, I can't take it and chuck it down the pipe, of course. Yeah, so there's pretty hilarious corruption going on is kind of what I'm trying to say. This is really nice, though. Man. Too bad he's going to have to sell this entire cathedral just to pay for the drug, and then it's going to kill him. God damn. That high priest confessor guy. Like, maybe he's the one who was on the balcony smoking some, too. Jesus Christ, man, what's going on here? Well, regardless, I'll be out of here soon. A thief doesn't become a drug addict. Oh, no, 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 no. However, I have this sinking suspicion I won't find any more clues if I somehow am not supposed to get any. "Lord Balcon, unfortunately, the city watch has become interested in your little endeavor. A couple of nights ago, two fools were heading home drunk and blurting out information about the casino and your wealth. I know the city watch has already requested someone to start inquiring, but it's not long now until the seedy underbelly of the city becomes interested too, Lord Michael." Wait, I see you there. "But first, the casino was only recently finished, and already we have a city watchman trying to stick his nose in my business. He became rather irate when I wouldn't let him look around, so my personal guards roughed him up a bit before locking him up in the cool room to cool off for a bit." Ah, that would explain it. "Come to think of it, did I ever tell them to take him out? Yes, that would explain it. Oh well, hopefully the watch doesn't send any more men around to inspect. Perhaps I need to visit the captain and make him an offer he can't refuse. I can't have my paying guests feeling threatened or unsafe with city watch members snooping around on their business." So he is treating it like a bed and breakfast. Oh, that's it, huh? Yep, that's what I thought. Well, we still got this, though. Oh. Okay, fine. It's got a lion's head on it. That's how you know it's hardcore. It's the easy never-pick tetraethyl lead-coated safe. For easy poisoning. Of people! Oh. Now that's cool.
I guess the house doesn't always win.
Oh, no. Oh, Jesus. Okay, for a minute I thought it was that frog bug. Alright. So, that's the optional. Now again, I could just end it. But also again, I'm just gonna go back to John's place and show you guys what the hell I'm talking about. I mean, it's all it's gonna get me is just some loot. I don't even need it. But, you know, hey, completionism. And also, I haven't really barely got any secrets. I kinda want to, but... meh. I don't wanna cheat and look them up. You know, what I get is what I get, and that rat thing... was that a secret? It should have been. I don't think it was, though, weirdly enough. But hey, you know, I accidentally stumbled into it, so... that makes up for stuff, I'm sure. So this is John's place over here, right? Well, if I don't need any more clues, then that could mean that somehow I'm supposed to deduce the whole thing from this note, which is impossible, because, like, those who stopped the execution, and then it says those who were with the executed, implying that they were executed, so how could it have been stopped? This doesn't even make sense in the first place. But how am I supposed to deduce from this? Like, those who stopped the execution, those who were with the executed, those who lost their lives, well... if nobody stopped it, then one person lost his life, and I don't know who was with him, and... I don't know who was in total. I can't deduce it from that. Don't patronize me, mate. Okay, well... I did have an idea that it could be in a painting. Now, there's paintings all over the place, but I guess I'll start here, because... this is the guy's place at... what? Sit your ass back down, you utter fool! You're blocking a painting. Are you doing it on purpose? Sit your ass back down, dude. Seriously. What? Oh, come on. All right. Don't you... me. I was able to get in here a whole bunch of times without him standing up. I don't know what the deal. Okay. Good. Alright. So there is some painting. Wow, that wolf's head is creepy. So there's some painting. Okay, that's just a painting of a guy. Anything else? Don't think so. Okay, moving on. What about around in here? Any paintings here? Well, there's this. Okay, it's not really an execution. It's some ships. I think he might have got up. I don't know. I don't have time to be worrying about that. Man, this is the mumble episode. Well, there's this. Now, I think I mentioned this before. I don't really know... yeah, I did joke about that, didn't I? Like, oh, head on the chopping block. Is this really an execution, though? Because it's not like a guillotine. How are they executing her? Dunking her head in the water? Is that water? Well, okay, let me just take a quick look around here just to see if there's any case. It's just a bathroom. There's nothing... okay, there is... well, if this is, as I joked, some sort of execution, then, like... what do we got? We got one woman being executed, I guess. We got with the executed, I guess. One guy and or everyone? But if it's everyone, then that's simple math. It's not that hard. Well, if it's... okay. If there's an executed, then I guess nobody stopped the execution. I guess that's a trick question, so it's probably zero something. So, like, one executed, one, two, three, four people with, quote-unquote... and what was the other one? Who is that one turning away? Maybe this is wrong. Oh, I'm using this voice now. So it was who stopped the execution, who died at the execution, who was with the executioner, and one other one. With, I guess, does that mean like the people who are not executing her? Because that's what I thought. I actually pictured it being more like people would be around her and a whole bunch of people would be totally not around her. Why am I stuttering? Well, so every time I alt-tab, it comes back stuttering. That's great. Okay, so, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 people at the execution in total, one being executed, and 5 minus 1 equals 4 with them and nobody stuttered. Okay, I'm gonna... 5 in total, and that's really all I actually need to know, I think. So let me just refresh my memory on the... stupid guy... order of things, those who stopped. So none, 4, 0, 4, 5, 1. So he got up, he did get up. 0, 4, 5, 1. Okay. 0, and these are weird. Like, I remember how to work these, because I tried it off camera. But it's not nearly as intuitive as is the thief style. It's really kind of silly. Like, once you know that they go up and down, then it's fine, but at first glance, they just look like a bunch of blank buttons that should have numbers on them that are twice as many as it looks like there should be, so... Hey, whatever.
Aw, oh, yeah.
And that's 3 of 8 secrets. 3 only. What? And now I gotta get out of here. Well, okay. Hey, don't you be hiccuping at me. Okay, I want to find the other 5 secrets, but I have no idea where they would be. Oh no, he didn't get up necessarily. I thought that shadow meant that he'd gotten up. And I don't want to artificially look them up. So, I can't believe I actually managed to figure that puzzle out also. It just freaking hit me. What? Okay, I... Shit. Also, I do have John's front door key, so I can lock this crap back up. Good. Yeah, so what the hell was I saying? Yeah, that, and I don't know where their secrets are, and I don't want to artificially find them. So, I guess I'll finish the mission. Because, yeah, get what you get. It's getting kind of silly. People are claiming that I'm a doctor for animals. Yeah, I guess the elevator does go for too long, but I guess it's just, you know, it's old school tech, it's slow, and all the secrets are before this place. Hey, he is using that new machine from the forum thread thing. Freaking great. So I guess this was like the super puzzle to get the door open, but I don't have to worry about that now because I'm friggin' done. So yeah, no secrets are here. And the fog is not here either. Am I not finished yet then? Well, there's no secrets, but evidently there's still some gameplay. Okay. So this is... Elevator leads to sewer hatch. So again, sewers, no map. Bunch of doors. Bunch of busted old crates, you know. Standard sewer stuff. Filth and no care about it. Strange bunch of... By order of the something loose bowel. Oh, yeah. Not a joke, but just a regular paper that's been chopped the heck up. I like these floating papers. Though, they're pretty neat. So all these strange tunnels that don't really go anywhere. Kind of weird. Oh, I guess I'm going over there where the note is. Fine. I guess there's no loot here either.
Corbin, the bounty on your head has grown so large that it has turned your allies against you. If you head down to the docks, you will be greeted by the city watch. I wish we could have met under better circumstances, but as usual, fate does not allow us this convenience. Everything will be explained soon, but for now, I need to bring you to a safe location. A portal will open nearby for you. Make haste, for the Reaper is coming.
Oh, well, I better turn off the light then. Also, a portal? What on earth? Okay. Ooh. Also, these bars exist for some reason. Whoa. What is that? Is that the actual Reaper? Would have thought he'd look a bit less stony. What? Oh, come on. Why is there a literal Reaper that's just a skull sticking out of a rock? That's kind of a weird decision. I mean, it is creepy. Sure. But, I thought by the Reaper you meant like somebody coming to collect a bounty on my head, but no, you meant it literally. I mean, that's... Yeah, I mean, it is creepy, sure, but I guess I just gotta run real quick. Whoa! Dude, that was awesome! Also, I'm not finished? Damn! Is this a keeper? Keeper spot? Dude, that was an incredible effect. Okay, I guess I'm not to be reading anymore. I just gotta hightail it somewhere or other. Fine, fine, fine. Kinda wanna sit around and read the Keeper books, obviously. Seems like the most important sort of priority. But what do I know? Obviously nothing. Maybe I can read this one. Huh? Yeah. Study of the human world. With plagues, infection, and drunken brawls spilling into the streets on a regular basis, life is much cheaper in this world than ours. The heads and corpses of criminals line the roads, and public torture and hangings are one of the most popular forms of entertainment. Watching criminals have their entrails cut out and burned while still alive is considered a good way to teach children moral lessons. Even the church, the main provider of hope and beauty in this age, enthusiastically tortures and burns heretics. For the poor, a dark bread of rye or barley, maybe with cheese and a bowl of curds, are typical meals. Servants and households are usually better fed, with beef or fowl for meats, better breads, pudding, salt herring, cheese, dried cod and ale, which is usually made on the premises. The middle-class merchant and minor nobility have access to higher quality food and a larger variety than the others. Oh, okay then. Oh, are we supposed to... Hang on, do I have ropes? No? That seems like just a light. What? Why am I here? Am I supposed to... What am I supposed to... Is there another way up? I don't think so. What? Am I supposed to find a hidden book in this mess? That seems unreasonable. That's totally not the case, because seriously, dude is way better than that. But, that's the human world. What? I mean, I get that I'm safe, sure, but I'm gonna rot in here! Alright, well, if there ain't nothing up there, then... Oh! What? Okay, this is awesome, supreme. Friendly skull,
for
I guess.
What seems an age, I have watched you, Mr. Corbin, and I must confess that you confuse me. Destiny has given you remarkable talents of moving through the night, unseen. Yet, you waste these gifts, stealing handfuls of coins like a dog taking scraps from a table. There must be some part of you that longs to be used in a more meaningful cause. Well, I can give you that cause, and even more. I can give you riches beyond your wildest dreams. There exist 4 red crystals hidden in the far corners of the earth. Their origins are the stuff of legends. Some say they hold the essence of a dying mage, and others that they are remnants of a long-forgotten race. To hold them is to hold power. And can take you to the location of the first crystal. In return, you can be my avatar, my agent on the earth. When you claim all 4 crystals, I will finally rest in peace. And as for you, well, Mr. Corbin, you will finally be able to afford the life you've always wanted. No longer needing to watch over your shoulder for the city watch. No longer being paranoid if your fence has sold you out or not. No longer having to steal just to afford your monthly rent, I will give you the greatest gift of all. A lifetime of comfort, wealth, and happiness to fulfill whatever desires you wish until the end of your days. When you are ready to begin, step into the portal behind me. It will take you to the first crystal. I have placed a protective shield surrounding it. However, other forces, like the being you saw tonight out there, and will stop at nothing until they have the crystals for their own devilish needs. You do not want to be found by these beings. Well, I have spoken much, and now it is time for you to act. I will be in contact again with you soon, Mr. Corbin. Good luck.
Okay. Wow. How do you do that? Wow. Okay, that was not at all what I was expecting, but... Oh, that is amazing looking. Whoa. Okay, this mission is like a freaking fantastic... find the four crystals optional. Wait. Wait, this whole thing's optional? Wait, so... Okay, I thought he was describing the plot of... like, the next missions in the series. Well, that guy must be lying if he isn't then, because there's more missions in the frickin' series. This is beautiful! I mean, the sky, it's like, obviously, we're inside the IMAX theater here, but, like, let's not ask too many questions. I think that I maybe can't trust this guy. I don't know. He has no name, but I call him the Wanderer. I don't know where he came from, what he is, or what he wants, but I do know that he will slay any soul he sees. I was one of the supposedly lucky few who managed to escape the castle alive when the earth tremors began. Most were crushed to death, and those who lived fell prey to sickness and famine. I tried to escape, but the city gates are locked and won't budge an inch. The tremors cause the mountains to come crashing down, which blocks any other way out. The days are long and the nights are cold. All I can hear is the sound of the Wanderer echoing through the air. I haven't eaten in days, so I decided to head into town to see what I could scavenge. I couldn't find much, unfortunately, and my search had to be cut short as I think I heard the faint whispering of the Wanderer. Afraid and in a hurry, I quickly ran through the house and locked the door, possibly making noise, but at the time I couldn't think clearly as I did not want to be found by him. I'm going to hide up here behind the waterfall as long as I can. I don't think he would ever think to look up here. But for now, I need rest, as I'm quite weak and wish to save my energy for another search of food in the town. Now, wait. Hang on. This is... says it's optional, but it isn't. Because I can't actually finish the mission without... Right? Like, I can't finish it without collecting the gems, so... So, I don't know why that's labeled as optional. That's a strange thing. But, okay, where is the gem? Is it not just here somewhere? That's funny. Well, okay. So, okay, I probably have to... Oh, what do I have to do? Where... Where's the gem? This is amazing. Like, I thought I would end the mission, so, like, I probably should stop it, but I don't think I have that long before I end it. I'm not sure. Maybe I can go into a portal without collecting the gem. That's gotta be the case, because otherwise... I don't know. This is just, like, amazing, though. You know, forgive me for being struck speechless by the kill and so forth. Whoa. Okay, there it is. No, it's just a red thing, not a red gem. It's a thing. So, am I gonna come up against the Wanderer? Is that the Reaper, or is it me, or is it that blue skull? Perhaps the blue skull and the Reaper are on the same side, or even one and the same. Not, you may notice, one in the same. Please speak your English greatly. Well... I heard a scream. That's good news, I guess. Wow, which way should I even go? Probably over there, but... I don't want to turn on my light lest I actually have to remain hidden or something. But I guess I will. Wait, there's multiple ways? Okay. Not loot. Weird, why? Oh. But all the secrets are before the sewers, so... Ooh, what the hell? Get the feeling that I'm in an ultra-secret place, though. Where the hell am I now? Oh, it's just a windmill. Okay. Jesus! Spooky. But I'm in a totally different section. Oh, God, I can't see anything, but I... I've got a bad feeling about this. I'll be honest with you. key. Going into the mines, I am gonna be fighting. Okay. Well, I don't know if I should leave it here. I don't think I should. But, well, you never know. I guess I'll carry on for a little while longer. After all, I've only gotten one crystal thus far. Okay, I just want to go back to the beginning. Wow, this reminds me of Rotomil or something. You know? It's pretty great. It's pretty great. Well, maybe I will leave it here. Because this seems a bit long. So next time we'll collect the gems, I suppose? See you guys weirdly, and bye for now.